This is my new favorite game. I'm gonna be sniping a fort. My method nowadays is to do my best without having to use any motorized vehicles. Sniper is completely upgraded. And here we go. Keeping low and shooting as many targets as you can is a good key to the sniper role. The machine gunners take more than one shot at times. The interesting thing I think about this is that you can machine gun to death, or even sniper, or just a regular rifle. Any one of these things will kill a tank or an armored car. And a sniper is actually pretty effective on one for some reason. Damn. That wasn't very long. At times I go faster and at times I go a little slower. There's always one guy that hides behind something, anything. If you don't hear a ping, then they missed you. Guys with the rockets are some of the most dangerous. There are motor vehicles everywhere, so if you're running out of armor, it can be a good idea to get into one of those. Long-range sniping is definitely one of the better assets in this game. To show you the assets one of these has, I will get in. To get in, you press E. Your gun aims just the same. You have a different weapon, of course, whatever's mounted on the vehicle. These have some sort of little heavy-duty repeating cannon, kind of like a 37mm or something of that kind. Like the effect of something blowing up. Yes, if you need to, you can run over people. Oh, shit. And this is what it looks like. inside of it. I'm going to actually go pick up this one. You'll notice this has 8 wheels. It's a completely different machine. Crap. Okay, here we go. Again, you just press E to enter. Some things, when you run over them, blow up or fall down. If you hit a barrel like that one that's red, it will blow things up. Frequently, the shrapnel will kill. That works well. I always ignite all of the barrels that I can because it can be really helpful. To get past here, there's actually a lot more. You have to go around this little hill. That guy's a pretty easy opponent, as you can see. This is the end screen when you've blown everything to smithereens. We're going to try out my machine gunner here, and we're going to do the Battle Royal. Oh wait, we'll do the Hidden Valley because it's only got 1 star. I will be using all of the motorized vehicles I can in this one. Thank you. well, it's really an advantage to you because we'll take out about a quarter of the enemies. Now you're ready to continue up the hill. At the top of this hill, there are multiple tanks and vehicles shooting at you. But there's also one for you to grab. You just have to remember where it's located. Okay, it's right down over here. We have to shoot these people first. Try not to shoot your vehicle because it does knock down the and if you hit a palm tree in a truck or a vehicle, it will knock it down. Because I put so many holes inside of that Humvee, but because of the amount of holes I put inside of it, I'm going to just stop and grab this new untainted car. Sometimes, as amazing as it may seem, it's actually easier to jump out of your vehicle to knock out another vehicle. For some reason, I don't know what that reason is yet. Your personal machine gun has more effect on vehicles than the ones mounted on stuff. So, until we get into the tanks, assets the vehicles give you is increased protection by quite a bit. Thank you. that is how you run over somebody. This thing is a son of a bitch. Watch what it does to a palm tree. Same thing that it would do if you ran over it. And it does that pretty effectively to other things too. This is kind of a flanking maneuver. Thank you. guess there are more. Let's see if I can remember how you get out of here. Oh, yeah. Better these big tanks are. You'll notice it takes quite a few rounds to destroy one. Around this hill. If you stick to hillsides, it can really help you sneak up on people, and it's a good advantage. But if you go too far, obviously you're out of the battle zone. Huh?